bag of letters from the earth.
Shall I read this letter? Please, please.
Yes, sure.
Our loving Heavenly Father, I am Annie from Earth. God, please show me in my dreams about your birth in Bethlehem. I am eager to see the baby Jesus.
Here comes the Archangel Michael.
Well, I remember clearly. It all started nearly 2,800 years ago. Here are the three important prophets who lived in Jerusalem and foretold the first coming of Christ.
I am Isaiah. The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son and will call him Emmanuel. It came to pass after 700 years.
I am Micah. O Bethlehem, though you're small among the clans of Judah, out of you will come the one who will be the ruler of Israel. It all came to pass after 500 years when baby Jesus was born in Bethlehem.
I am Zechariah. Rejoice greatly, daughter Zion. Shout, daughter Jerusalem. See, your king comes to you, lowly and riding on a donkey, on a colt, the foal of a donkey. It all came to pass after 430 years when Jesus rode on a donkey entering Jerusalem.
Could you please tell us in detail about the first Christmas?
Sure. It was the great mission executed by Gabriel, our messenger angel. Only he can tell us in detail.
My work started around 2,000 years ago. I paid my first visitation to the high priest Zechariah and stood on the right side of the altar of incense and said to him, "Fear not, your prayers were heard and your wife Elizabeth would bear a son and you should name him John. He shall be great in the sight of the Lord. He will be filled with the anointing of the Holy Spirit even from his mother's womb. Through him, many will come to know the living truth and he will prepare the way for Jesus Christ."
Oh, now I remember. It is the same John the Baptist who anointed the Lord Jesus in River Jordan.
Well said. Exactly after 6 months, I visited the young Jewish woman, Mary of Nazareth, and said to her, "Hail, you are highly favored, the Lord is with you. You are blessed among the women. Fear not, you would conceive and give birth to a baby who is the Son of the High God, as the Holy Spirit of God overshadows you."
Mary, on hearing that, her relation Elizabeth, who was barren, is now in her 6th month, paid a visit to her. When both met, the babe in Elizabeth's womb was excited on hearing Mary's sweet greeting. Elizabeth in turn blessed Mary, saying, "You are blessed among women."
Go.
Mary, do you know that your baby boy would one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you delivered will soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy will give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will calm the storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels draw? When you kiss your little baby, you kiss the face of God. Oh Mary, did you know?
So, when did Joseph get to know that Mary was pregnant?
Thirdly, I visited Joseph in his dream. He was the carpenter of Nazareth to whom Mary was engaged to be wedded. He was very much worried when he found out that Mary was expecting a baby before their marriage. I said to him, "Don't be afraid to have Mary as your wife."
Gabriel explained that Mary had been chosen by God to be the mother of a son and also clarified that the baby would be named as Jesus, which means Savior, because he would save people. Joseph took Mary as his wife. Finally, when time for the prophecy came to pass, the host of angels came to earth and appeared before the shepherds who were watching their flocks in the field.
Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in clothes and lying in a manger.
Guided by the star, three wise men came from the east and worshipped baby Jesus.
Chapter 16, verse 15. Behold, I come like a thief. Blessed is he who watcheth and keepeth his garments, lest he walk naked and they see his shame.
Oh, it's terrible to hear. How about the throne of judgment?
It is written in Revelation chapter 20, verses 11 to 15. And then I saw a great white throne and him who was seated on it. The earth and the heavens fled from his presence, and there was no place for them. And I saw the dead, great and small, standing before the thrones, and the book was opened. Another book was opened, which is the book of life. The dead were judged according to what they had done, as recorded in the books. The sea gave up the dead that were in it, and death and Hades gave up the dead that were in them. Then death and Hades were thrown into the lake of fire. The lake of fire is the second death. Anyone whose name was not found written in the book of life was thrown into the lake of fire.
That Pharaoh's daughter pulled out an ark carrying a Hebrew child from the river Nile and named him Moses, who became the liberator of Israelites. And he performed great miracles like dividing the Red Sea, bringing water out of a rock, turning bitter water sweet, etc. Our founder, Miss Jessie Moses, gave the motto "Founded on the Rock" to our school, which is named after her. The Word of God says that Jesus Christ is the rock of our salvation and is the spring of living waters. And whosoever drinketh this water will never thirst, but in their hearts flow rivers of peace, love, and joy. Our Lord has rebuked the wind and storm and calmed the tempest and walked over the waters. In this world of hatred, bitterness, and misery that drift our lives like storm, our school, like a lighthouse, lead the children towards the everlasting sweetness of God's love, peace, and joy. May this Christmas bring home these blessings, and may your lives be flourished like the garden watered by the love of Jesus Christ our Lord.
Now may I request our correspondent, Mrs. Lenora James, to come forward and close it with a prayer.
Some of you are here. Could you rise to your feet, please? Could you all stand? Thank you. Heavenly Father, we thank and praise you for today, a beautiful day when we watch the talents of our children being displayed. We thank you, Lord, for the teachers, for the principal, for the workers, and all who put in such hard work for this wonderful performance to spread the good news and to tell our parents that you are ready to give us the living waters and we will thirst no more. Father, continue to be with the Jesseans and bless them more and more. We praise you. We glorify you. We thank you, Lord, for good weather. We thank you for these beautiful children. We thank you for the staff. We thank you for the workers. And we thank you for the parents who have entrusted their children to our care. Continue to be on this campus and bless every moment, every event, every classroom with your presence. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you.